shall we follow the law of Moses or not?
If any of you are without sin, you may cast the first stone. Does no one condemn you? Then neither do I condemn you. Go now and sin no more.
Wait! Those men! I don't.
I know.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you.
Let the children come to me. Let the children come. Don't stop them. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. I tell you, if any of you do not have the faith of a child, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven.
To inherit eternal life.
Why do you call me good? For only God is good. You know the commandments. Do not steal, do not murder, do not commit adultery, do not falsely testify. Honor your father and mother. Love your neighbor as yourself.
But all these things I've done since I was a child.
There is one thing you still lack. Go now and sell all you have. Give the money to the poor, and you will have treasures in heaven. Then come and follow me. How hard is it for a rich person to enter the kingdom of heaven? It's easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich person to enter the kingdom of heaven.
Well, then who can be saved?
For man, it is impossible to be saved, but not with God. With God, all things are possible.
But Lord, we have left everything to follow you. Will there be a reward for us?
I assure you that when I, the Son of Man, sit upon my glorious throne in the kingdom of heaven, you who have been my followers will also sit on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And any of you who have given up houses, brothers or sisters, fathers or mothers, children or property, for my sake will receive 100 times as much, and will have eternal life. For those who are considered the most important here and now will be the least in the kingdom, and those who are considered the least will be the greatest.
Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me! 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 No, no, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me! Jesus, Son of David, please have mercy on me! Have mercy on me, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me!
Don't worry. What do you want me to do for you?
Lord, I want to see.
All right. You can see. It is your faith that has healed you.
Wow.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
I can see the sky. It's blue. It's well there. I can see it. Oh, my father. I don't know what I can see. Oh, I can see. Oh,
everywhere he goes, Jesus brings light and life to all those who seek him. In one way or another, they are all touched and changed by Jesus' love and compassion. Let us begin by following Jesus to the city. It is the spring of the year AD 31, and Jerusalem is bustling and booming with people who have come from all over to celebrate Passover. Most are from Judea, but others have come from even further to celebrate this occasion.
Thank you.
After Jesus triumphantly entered the city, he went to the temple and drove out the money changers and merchants. He then taught in the temple for the rest of the week, and on Thursday sent his disciples to prepare the room for a Passover meal. Let us now follow the disciples deeper into the city, to the upper room where they will later have their meal together.
here to wash our feet.
You're right.
You had your mother ask Jesus, who will wash our feet?
Jesus, we never got over that.
Did she really think
the Messiah would have two fishermen seated beside him in his kingdom? I've seen Jesus do some strange things, but I think that's a stretch even for him.
Hey, Jesus, you seem to be forgetting something. The first two disciples were fishermen.
Well, the fishermen might have been first. But you two, just like Peter, the greatest fisherman of all, don't listen, do you? Can't you remember that Jesus said the first will be last?
You have a point. They don't listen, at least not carefully. He said, blessed are the poor in spirit, not the poor in mind. If you fishermen are so close to Jesus, why didn't he trust one of you to be the treasurer?
Treasurer? When Jesus raised Jairus' daughter, did he ask for his treasurer? No, he asked for his fishes of men. When Jesus took us up into the mountains and explained, I can't even explain things that we have seen up there, did he ask for his treasurer? No, he asked for his fishes of men.
Since he's so used to asking his fishes of men to do everything, maybe he'll find some of you to wash our feet.
You know that the rulers of the people of this world exercise authority over them. It should not be like this among you. Whoever wants to be a leader among you must first be your servant. Do you understand what I have done? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right because it is true. And since I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash each other's feet. I have looked forward to this hour with deep longing, anxious to eat this Passover meal with you before my suffering. I tell you, this will be the last time I eat it until it comes to fulfillment in the kingdom of God.
Lord, no, don't say that.
Take it and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
What?
Each of you, drink from it, for this is my blood, which seals the covenant between God and his people.
Your blood?
It is poured out to forgive the sins of many.
Your blood? What are you talking about like this?
But here at this table, sitting among us as a friend is the man who will betray me.
No. Is it me?
Hey Lord, who is it?
It is the one with whom I dip the bread in the sauce.
What does that mean? I have no idea.
yourself. What you are planning to do, do quickly. Tonight, all of you will desert me. For the scriptures say, God will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will scatter.
No, Lord, please.
But after I have been raised from the dead, I will go ahead of you to Galilee, and I will meet you there.
Lord, that will never happen. Even if all of these deny you and desert you, I never will leave you, Lord. I will die for you.
Die for me. Peter, before the rooster crows tomorrow morning, you will deny me 3 times.
Lord, that's simply not true. Lord, I would die for you. I would never deny you.
Don't be troubled. Don't be troubled. You believe in God. And you must believe in me. In my Father's home are many, many rooms, and I am going to prepare a place for you. If this were not so, I would have told you. When everything is ready, I will come back and get you, so that you may always be with me wherever I am, and know where I am going, and how to get there.
No, Lord, we haven't any idea. We just don't know where you're going. So how can we know the way?
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. If you know the Father, then you know me. Do you not believe that the Father is in me, and I in the Father? I do not speak these words of my own authority, but of the Father who dwells in me. He does the work, and will do greater still. Peace I leave you, so do not let your heart be troubled or afraid.
Shalom, my friend, shalom, my friend, shalom, shalom. May peace be with you, God's peace be with you, shalom, shalom.
Life on this earth is drawing to an end. Please follow Jesus and his disciples closely. Yeah.
sit here while I go ahead to pray. Peter, James, John, come with me. My soul is crushed with grief to the point of death. Stay here and watch with me. Abba, Father, everything is possible for you. Please take this cup of suffering away. Yet, it is not my will, but your will that must be done. Simon,
yes,
are you asleep? Could you not stay awake and watch with me for at least 1 hour? Stay alert and pray. Otherwise, temptation will overcome you. The spirit is willing enough, but the body is weak. Father, if this cup cannot be taken away until I drink it, your will be done. Father, please take this cup from me. But if I must drink it, your will be done. Are you all still sleeping and resting? Enough! The time has come. I, the Son of Man, am betrayed into the hands of sinners. See, my betrayer is at hand. Judas, how could you betray the Son of Man with a kiss? Lord, what should we do?
We have swords. Shall we fight?
Dangerous criminal, that you come armed to arrest me. You could have arrested me in the temple. I was there teaching every day. Yet you come to me in this hour of darkness.
I'm sorry, Jesus, but I'm going to have to take it to the high priest.
Thank you.
Jesus is being taken to the high priest for a trial before the Sanhedrin. The disciples have deserted him, just as Jesus predicted. Kelsey, can you prompt? Just as Jesus predicted. Peter, however, I can't remember it. What is it? Follows the crowd at a distance to see what the outcome will be. He has not completely abandoned Christ, at least not yet. Quickly now, let's follow the crowd.
Crucified. Oh, yeah. 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 Yeah.
The governor's soldiers took Jesus into the praetorium to be whipped. The whole company of soldiers gathered around. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and then twisted a crown of thorns together and set it on his head. They put a staff in his right hand and knelt in front of him and mocked him. They spat on him and twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on his head. Then they led him away to be crucified. Please follow closely as Jesus takes his final steps on the Via Dolorosa.
After the last tear falls, after the last secret's told, after the last bullet tears through flesh and bone, after the last child starves and the last girl walks the boulevard, after the last year that's just been to her. Love, 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 there is love. Love, 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 there is love. After the last disgrace, after the last light saves some face, after the last brutal jab from a poison tongue, after the last dirty politician, after the last meal down at the mission, after the last lonely night in prison, there is love, 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 there is love, 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 there is love. And in the end is the oceans of love. Love and love again. We'll see the tears that have fallen were caught in the palms of the giver of love and the lover of all. And we'll look back on these tears as old tales. 'Cause after the last plan fails, after the last siren wails, after the last young husband sails off to join the war, love, 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 there is love, 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 love. And the end is the oceans and oceans of love and love again. We'll see how the tears that have fallen were caught in the palms, the giver of love and the lover of all. We'll look back on these tears as old tales. 'Cause after the last tears fall, there is love. 'Cause after the last tears fall, there is love. 'Cause after the last tear falls, there is love, there is love.
Thank you. but he cannot save himself.
He claims he's the king of the Jews. We'll believe in him if he comes down now.
Christ, save yourself and save us.
Don't you fear God? He is innocent. We deserve to die. Lord, remember me when you reach.
Tell you the truth. You will be with me in paradise. Mother, he is your son. John. She is your mother.
This darkness is eerie. It's been going on since the sixth hour, and we're almost at the ninth.
Eli!
Thank you.
This has to be the place. I don't know if I can be here. Why am I here? Jesus meant so much to me. I was a leper. Unclean. Jesus healed me. I don't know why I'm here either. I guess I just need to see his grave for myself. This isn't right, Marcus. I was dead in a tomb. It was like being wakened from a deep sleep. And I heard a faint voice, Lazarus, Lazarus. And I started to panic. Where am I? What's going on? And it got louder. Lazarus, Lazarus, come forth. It was a soft but commanding voice. And then it happened. My fingers started moving. My toes wiggling. My legs, my arms. I got this strange feeling. And the next thing I know, the shroud is being unwrapped from my face. And it was him. Jesus. I was dead. And he gave me life again. Look, I understand that you want to leave, but please, just stay with me. I'm not even here for you. I'm sorry. I need to be here. I just don't want to be here. He meant so much to me. Parts of me were gone. I was numb, not only in my fingers and toes, but on the inside. When Jesus healed me, he didn't just heal my fingers and toes. He healed my heart as well. He made me whole. And now I just feel like everything is missing. This isn't fair! He's beat death before with me! I was dead! Look at me now! Look at us! I just don't understand it. How can he be dead? How can he be dead?
Soldiers' feet as they guard the grave. One day, 2 days, 3 days had passed. Could it be that Jesus breathed his last? Could it be that his father had forsaken him? Turned his back on his son, despising our sin. Oh, how seemed to whisper, just forget it, he's dead. Then his father looked down to his son and he said, arise, my love. My love, the grave no longer has a hold on you. No more death's sting, no more suffering. Arise, arise, my earth trembled and the tomb began to shake. And like lightning from heaven, the stone was rolled away. And this dead man, the guards, they all stood there in fright as the sound of victory displayed its might. And suddenly a melody filled the air, riding wings of wind. It was everywhere. The words of creation had been longing to hear the sweet sound of victory, so loud and clear. Arise, my love, arise, my love. The grave no longer has a hold on you. No more death sting, no more suffering. Arise, arise. Where are your shackles? Where is your sting? Has been defeated, the grave could not hold the king. Arise, my love, arise, my love. The grave no longer has a hold on you. No more death's chain, no more suffering. Arise, arise, arise.
All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely, I will be with you always, to the very end of the age.
That was the end of the performance, and I'm sure you'd like to give thanks to all those who have taken part, but particularly to those who worked on it very hard. And this goes out to Kimberly and Kelsey, our two student missionaries who've been here now since last September. I don't know if it's appropriate to give them a round of applause. And I'd like to invite you all to stand, and Dave Burgess will come and give a closing prayer.
Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the story that we have just witnessed this evening. We thank you that you sent your Son so that we could learn of the love that you have for each one of us, who died for us so that our sins could be forgiven once and for all, and that if we believe, we can be with you for eternity in heaven. Loving Father, may each of us take home that story in our hearts this evening. May each of us give our lives to you, so that we can be with you forever. Bless us now as we go from here. Be with us all weekend as we dwell on the things of 2,000 years ago, we pray, for Jesus' sake. Amen.
Can I just invite you all to come back tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock? We have another worship service here. It is our communion service tomorrow, and it's open for everybody who would like to join us. In the evening, we have the Romanian children's choir coming here at 7:30 to sing to us. A very good evening, and we look forward to seeing you tomorrow. There are refreshments in the Cedar Sycamore Room, the new centre. We invite you all to come and join us there. Thank you.